I'm here with Philip Kelly, Director of Wireless Standards with Alcatel-Lucent. Philip, you're very welcome to the World Telecommunication Development Conference.
Thank you very much for this opportunity.
I know in Alcatel-Lucent you're working a lot in the area of ICTs and climate change, and you in the area of wireless standards. Can you help us understand a little bit how they're connected and how you're contributing to mitigating the effects of climate change?
Yes, well, you know, the energy consumption is becoming a very important item in the design of new networks. It's not just a question of minimizing the cost of equipment, it's also a question of minimizing the energy and the OPEX. And for that reason, in the design of the new networks, sometimes called 5G, we are paying a great attention to this aspect of the requirements. In particular, while working within the ITUR sector, in what they called the requirements for IMT beyond 2020.
And you mentioned there 5G. Can you tell us a little bit about that? I know that's some time in the future, but and how that will also contribute to climate change issues.
Well, first of all, 5G is not a correct denomination for ITU. ITU prefers to speak of IMT beyond 2020. That's ITUR sector. But the expectation is that we can reduce the energy consumption of networks by a factor of 1,000 from the state of affairs in 2010. And in my company, we have a research lab called Bell Labs, which has been leading the Green Touch Consortium on this ambitious initiative.
And with the rollout of 4G happening now and 5G coming beyond 2020 and the ambitions that we have for a connected worldwide community, which will mean a greater proliferation of devices, are there concerns about the contributory factor to environmental issues in terms of e-waste?
Well, you see, we envisage, or we foresee, an increase of 25 times the traffic between 2010 and 2016. And with this increase, of course, there's an increase of equipment, an increase of devices, an increase of energy consumption. So, of course, e-waste must be seriously considered and taken into account. And in particular, when we measure the impact on greenhouse gas emission of our industry, like currently Green Touch, but also the Jay-Z and other initiatives do, we should not forget, you know, the end of a cycle and the disposal of the equipment at the end in terms of, you know, energy cost and costs of and greenhouse gas consumption emission.
Philip Kelly, thank you very much.
You're welcome. My pleasure.